Jira Cloud has two ways to search for issues, basic search and advanced search. In addition to different search methods, you can save your searches in Jira. These saved searches are known as filters, which you can use in boards, dashboards, and filter subscriptions in Jira. On the left sidebar, there is a magnifying glass indicating a search interface. The pop-up that opens allows you to view some recent issues, boards, and projects. The quick search bar at the top of the panel will update a list of search results as you type. But if you want more control over your search, you need to open the issue navigator, either by hitting enter from this screen, selecting view all issues, or selecting search issues under the issues and filters menu. From here, you can toggle between basic and advanced search. Let's take a look at running a basic search first. Basic search is the search option with drop-down menus. This option allows you to quickly narrow down your issues in Jira and find what you need. To do this, click the magnifying glass from the global sidebar. At this point, you could enter some text to start a search, but I'm going to click View All Issues. Now we see what's called the Issue Navigator, and we're going to use the drop-down menus to narrow our search. So for example, we're going to select the Customer Service Department Project. So now we see a smaller range of issues, but we want to further narrow it down, so we will select the issue type of complaint. And now we see just a couple of issues. Basic search is quick and easy. However, you may want to use advanced search to create more complex searches and filters. Advanced search in Jira uses JQL, or Jira Query Language, to perform its searches. This language is not the same as SQL, though you may recognize some similarities between the two if you are familiar with SQL. JQL doesn't change the database in Jira, so you're totally safe using it to search. The basics of JQL include a field which indicates where the search will look, so for example, project or assignee, an operator, which is the symbol that represents the way the field interacts with the value in the query, for example, the equal sign, and lastly, a value, which is your query's specific value. So when you're looking for a specific project, it would be the name or the project key of that project. For example, CSD. Put those three together and you have field plus operator plus value equals your query. Let's look at this process in action. We're just going to perform a relatively simple advanced search to introduce you to the topic. If you are interested in learning more about advanced searching in Jira, Atlassian provides a lot of documentation to help. Link below. Or consider checking out our paid content on Adaptavist Learn. For now, let's search for issues assigned to Abby Levine. Remember, we get to the Issue Navigator from the search icon in the global sidebar, and in the Issue Navigator, we click Advanced. Now we just see a blank field. Here's where we're going to enter some JQL. Remember, field, operator, value. So for our example, we're going to type assignee equals learn Abby. You may notice that options appear as you start typing. Jira includes some help when you're working with JQL, which is great when you're first getting started. Press Enter to see your results, and you'll see all the issues assigned to Abby in the entire Jira instance, which actually might be a little bit too much. Let's try another bit of JQL to narrow down to a certain status. In the Advanced field, we add and status equals to do and press enter. And now we just see a few issues assigned to Abby in the to do status. Pro tip, when you're starting out with JQL, you can always perform a basic search and then switch to advanced to see the JQL behind your basic search. That method is a great way to become familiar with JQL. Once you have your search completed, you can turn that search into a filter. Let's go ahead and do that now. So next to search, we're going to click Save As. In the Save Filter window, next to filter name, we're going to type a name for this filter. Choose a name that makes sense and describes the search you perform. So we're going to say Abby To-Do List. And then just click Submit. Now you see the name of your filter at the top of the screen. You can do a lot with saved filters, including using them on dashboards, which we cover in a different video. Find a link to that video below, along with some other resources you might need.